Hi everyone, my name is Busari Abiodun. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to discuss about accounting standard, under which we'll be looking at International Accounting Standard Board, which is IASB, and International Financial Reporting Standard, which is IFRS. Also, we will be looking at Nigeria Accounting Standard Board, which is now known as Financial Reporting Council of Nigeria. So let's start with accounting standard. What is accounting standard? Accounting standard can be described as a statement made by the authorized body saddled with the responsibility of setting accounting standard, be it locally or internationally, the compliance of which is mandatory by the preparer and users of financial statement. With me, this standard, it is mandatory for the preparer and users of financial statement to follow this standard in the process. So every country has the body that is responsible for the setting out of accounting standard. In Nigeria, the accounting standard are issued by the Financial Reporting Council of Nigeria, FRCN, which was formerly known as Nigeria Accounting Standard Board. So now let's look at the history of accounting standard. The history of accounting standard can be traced back to the formation of International Accounting Standard Committee in 1973, a body that was set up to prepare, to produce, to develop standard for the preparer and users of financial statements. In 1989, the committee published a report, published a document named a framework, which set out the financial statement, how the financial statement to be prepared and the information to be presented. So 25 years after the formation of the body, which was between the period of 1997 and 2000, there was restructuring within the system, which led to the formation of a committee in 1997 to look at the activities of the body. In 1998, the committee produced a report which was presented to the board, IASB board. In 1999, the IASB board approved the report and presented it to the members in 2000. So the approval of this report led to the release of IASB constitution in 2001, and this release of this constitution was what led to the end of the defunct IASC and the formation of new body, which was called IASC Foundation, which is now known as IFRS Foundation. Now, IASC Foundation. So in 2001, the foundation set up an International Accounting Standard Board and the trustee. That is, after the new body has been formed, the new body set up two different bodies, which comprises of International Accounting Standard Board, which we call IASB, and the trustee. So the IASB is saddled with this responsibility of setting accounting standard, why to maintain the smooth flow of the activities and the independence of the IASB body. So the trustee was set up to finance and safeguard the activities of the IASB. So the standard released by this body under the IASC, that is between the period of 1973 and 2001, the accounting standard that is released by the IASC is called International Accounting Standard, IAS. And between those period, 41 standards has been released by the body, which ranging from IAS 1, IAS 2, IAS 3 down to IAS 41. So after the new body emerged, which is under the IFRS Foundation, the name of the standard being released changed to International Financial Reporting Standard, IFRS, while the former standard still remain as IAS. But the former standard are subjected to review or replacement. And under the IFRS, till today, the total number of the standard that are being released by the IFRS Foundation is 17, which ranges from IFRS 1, IFRS 2, IFRS 3, down to IFRS 17. Now, let us look at the list of accounting standard that was released by the default IASC. This include IAS 1, presentation of financial statements, IAS 2, inventory, IAS 3, consolidated financial statement, IAS 4, depreciation accounting, IAS 5, information to be disclosed in financial statement, IAS 6, accounting response to changing prices, IAS 7, statement of cash flow, IAS 8, accounting policies, changes in accounting estimate and error, IAS 9, accounting for research and development activities, IAS 10, event after reporting period, IAS 11, construction contract, IAS 12, income tax, IAS 13, presentation of current assets and current liabilities, IAS 14, reporting financial information by segment, IAS 15, information reflecting the effect of changing prices, IAS 16, property, plant and equipment, IAS 17, lease, IAS 18, revenue, IAS 19, employee benefit, IAS 20, accounting for government grants and disclosure of government assistance, IAS 21, the effect of changing in foreign exchange rate, IAS 22, business combination, IAS 23, borrowing cost, IAS 24, related party disclosure, IAS 25, accounting for investment, IAS 26, accounting and reporting by retirement benefit plan, IAS 27, separate financial statement, IAS 28, investment in associate and joint ventures, IAS 29, financial reporting in hyperinflationary economies, IAS 30, disclosure in financial statements of banks and similar financial institutions, IAS 32, interest in joint ventures, IAS 33, financial instrument presentation, IAS 33, earning per share, IAS 34, internal financial reporting, IAS 35, discontinued operation, IAS 36, impairment of asset, IAS 37, provisions, contingent liabilities and contingent assets, IAS 38, intangible assets, IAS 39, financial instrument recognition and measurement, IAS 40, investment property, IAS 41, which is agriculture. Those are the 41 standards released by the default IASC. But some of these standards have been merged to form another standard or removed and replaced. So now let's look at the list of the standard that has been removed. So the standard that has been removed among this IAS includes IAS 3, IAS 4, IAS 5, IAS 6, IAS 9, IAS 13, IAS 14, IAS 15, IAS 22, IAS 25, IAS 30, IAS 31, and IAS 35. Now, what are the remaining IAS? So out of the 41 international accounting standard that we have, that is IAS 1 to IAS 41, we have just 28 standard remain as at today, which are the one that appear on the screen, which are IAS 1, IAS 2, IAS 7, IAS 8, IAS 10, 11, 12, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 23, 24, 26, 27, 28, 29, 32, 33, 34, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, and 41. Those are the 28 IAS standards that remain. So under the new body, which is IFRS, let us look at the number of accounting standard released by the IFRS so far. This include IFRS 1, first time adoption of international financial reporting standard, IFRS 2, share-based payment, IFRS 3, business combination, IFRS 4, insurance contract, IFRS 5, non-current assets and sale and discontinued operation, IFRS 6, exploration and evaluation of mineral resources, IFRS 7, financial instrument disclosures, IFRS 8, operating segment, IFRS 9, financial instruments, IFRS 10, consolidated financial statement, IFRS 11, joint arrangement, IFRS 12, disclosure of interest in other entities, IFRS 13, fair value measurement, IFRS 14, regulatory deferral accounts, IFRS 15, revenue from contract with customers, IFRS 16, lease, IFRS 17, insurance contract. Those are the IFRS standard that has been released by the IFRS Foundation, by the IASB, International Accounting Standard Board, under the IFRS Foundation as at today. Now, let's quickly look at the accounting standard in Nigeria. So the Financial Reporting Council of Nigeria, the body was established in 1982 as Nigeria Accounting Standard Board, NASB, to set standard for the preparer and users of financial information in Nigeria. But in 2010, the Nigerian government moved for the adoption of IFRS. As at then, over 122 countries have joined IFRS standard. Just like I said earlier, every country has their own standard setting body, which means if an accountant in a country moves from his country to another country, he may has to undertake training on how to prepare account in that country. And that's the reason why we have the IFRS, in which all the member countries will prepare account in line with the IFRS standard, which means any member that is moving from one IFRS country to another will not have problem of retraining, because the system of preparing account is the same. So that's the reason why in 2010 the Nigerian government take the move to also join other countries who have employed the IFRS based accounting. So in 2011, the Financial Reporting Council of Nigeria Act 2011 was signed by the then President Goodluck Ebele Jonathan. So this led to the end of the defunct Nigeria Accounting Standard Board, NASB, and that was when the new body emerged, the Financial Reporting Council, FRCN of Nigeria. So the standard issued by the NASB before the adoption of IFRS is called Statement of Accounting Standard, SAS. And as at then, 30 standards has been released by the NASB, that is SAS 1 to SAS 30. Before we go, let's quickly look at the list of accounting standards released by the Nigeria Accounting Standard Board. This include SAS 1, disclosure of accounting policies; SAS 2, information to be disclosed in the financial statement; SAS 3, accounting for property, plant and equipment; SAS 4, stocks; SAS 5, construction contract; SAS 6, extraordinary items and prior year adjustment; SAS 7, foreign currency conversions and translation; SAS 8, accounting for employees' retirement benefits; SAS 9, accounting for depreciation; SAS 10, accounting for banks and non-bank financial institutions. That's part 1. SAS 11, lease; SAS 12, accounting for deferred taxes; SAS 13, accounting for investment; SAS 14, accounting for petroleum industry upstream activities; SAS 15, accounting for bank and non-bank financial institution, part 2; SAS 16, accounting for insurance business; SAS 17, accounting for petroleum industry downstream activities; SAS 18, statement of cash flow; SAS 19, accounting for taxes; SAS 20, bridged financial statement; SAS 21, earning per share; SAS 22, research and development cost; SAS 23, provision, contingent liabilities and contingent assets; SAS 24, segment reporting; SAS 25, telecommunication activities; SAS 26, business combination; SAS 27, consolidated and separate financial statement; SAS 28, investment in associate; SAS 29, interest in joint ventures; SAS 30, interim financial reporting. Those are the list of SAS, that is Statement of Accounting Standard, that are released by the Nigeria Accounting Standard Board. But since the adoption of the IFRS and since the formation of Financial Reporting Council of Nigeria, the IFRS based system of accounting has been adopted, and that is what is now being used till today.